They are the moments that were denied.
Miller makes a spectacular save!
Sure goals that were somehow kept out.
Years later, I try to not remember that save.
From grand larceny.
He robbed him! Call it copy, Rob Delmore blind!
To goal line leather.
Oh, a miraculous stop by the Blackhawks! Game saver!
And even disbelief.
Score, Sammy! Are they going to rule no goal?
The top 10 NHL saves are coming up next. Hi, everybody, and welcome to another SportsCenter Top 10 special. I'm Darren Detition. We are glad that you tuned in. And during the course of the next half hour, we're going to take a look at some of the best saves ever. They'll make you dizzy. Now, normally, goalies hate watching highlights because all we do is show a lot of goals. But this show is for the elephants. Here's number 10.
Well, Curtis Joseph stood in his head through that whole series.
Here's a break.
It was always our feeling that he was stealing games.
Perfect shot, hit him at Basson! Wow!
It's hard to remember one team outplaying another team that badly and going to a seventh game.
The action is unbelievable here in Dallas.
In overtime in a game seven, there's not too many smiles.
Hooked it up the near side to Sador. Sador looking to center. Sador, wraparound chance. Kuzer batted it once. Oh!
There was nothing but air. And then there was Cucho.
We felt the game was over. The bench was up. When you had Joe with the puck in that area, it was money in the bank.
The puck came from his left corner and right across, and I was kind of falling down and got good wood on it, but he made an incredible glove save that I think I still remember to this day.
On the bench, I was like, all right, let's shake hands. It looked like it was over, especially when it's on a stick like Joe Nieuwendyk's.
He's around.
Almost like the air went off the bench when he made that save.
You cannot believe that save by Curtis Joseph.
Curtis Joseph was always the best goaltender when he had to carry his team. He always seemed comfortable with that.
We fed off that momentum and shortly after, you know, Todd Marchand went wheeling down the wing and ended it.
Rushing the center and down the wing. It is Marchand! Scores! Marchand scores! And the Edmonton Oilers are going to move on. Curtis Joseph, the hero.
That save for me is like a bad dream. That series is a little bit like a bad dream because it was, you know, we had higher aspirations.
That was a great Dallas team. That was a Dallas team that was 2 years away from winning the Stanley Cup.
Seems you always remember the one that got away, and that was because of the save that Cujo made.
We were down 3-2 in the series, and it was a really long game.
We're going in overtime, and that's a game where we can clinch and move on to go to conference final.
In preparation for overtime. Sharks were the better team in the third period.
It was a tie, and we were in the fourth period or first in overtime.
Looking for his first Stanley Cup.
We got stuck a little bit in the zone, and Brad was in the back door sneaking out.
Wants to. Here's Richards a chance. Quick shot. Rebound. The Edmund. In front of Richards. Oh, a miraculous stop by the Blackhawks. Game saver.
One of those quick bang bang plays when you swear it's in. You're not sure if it's a goal or in. You go to the replay, you see the replay, and you're looking up, and you're like, that puck looks in.
At first, from the bench, I thought it was in. I thought the glove like passed the red line, but after the review, like we saw clearly that it wasn't in.
Did that puck go in? The light flashed ever so briefly.
He doesn't make that. His season is over.
The Blackhawks pretty confident. It's going to go his way.
You're never 100% sure, but I was hoping that I was there on time.
Richard has the puck. He's wide open. And Richard doesn't miss too many of those shots.
The overhead, we'll see if this puck goes in the net, but it's got to be conclusive.
That's a save.
That's a save, yep.
That's the save
of the playoffs.
We were playing in Philadelphia, and I always like playing in Philadelphia as a visiting team because it's always noisy and always loud, and it's always fun. I don't know why I felt like it was a need for me to go to the corner and play that puck.
You're on well the net and got trapped out there as he bumps in the corner.
If I remember correctly, John LeClair came in and kind of bumped into me and took me out of the play. Then went right to Andy Delmore, who was skating into what would have been his first NHL goal.
Here it is in front of the net. The goal! The goal! Incredible save!
So I'm just like full tilt back to the net. It's one of those moments where you dive and you think you actually have a chance at it, where you, there's one in a million chance of you hitting it.
Unbelievable. That was something.
Having one of the best play-by-play guy in the league in Rick Jenneret, the sound bite from the save is just as good as the save itself.
You're on way out of the net and got trapped out there as he bumps in the corner. Here it is in front of the net.
I got to play with Andy in Buffalo for a few months, and he came to me and I introduced myself to him, and he goes, you know, he robbed me of my very first NHL goal. And he's like, you're lucky I got to score later that year, because, you know, you never know what happens. You don't play another NHL game and you say, you know, you had the perfect opportunity. It was one of my probably most memorable saves that I've made. And it wasn't a good one. It just was a very lucky one.
Well, it's one of those things you get cut behind the net playing the puck, and
they should. An honest effort every single night. The play, a steal, Perron lost it, and a shot that could go in or not. No, it did not go in. The goal judge turned the light on. They reacted, but Perron kept that puck out of there.
I think he came to play the puck a little bit behind the net. Mikey Ribeiro might have stripped him of it and came around the net and pretty much had an open net. Went to fire it top shelf in glamorous fashion.
Ribeiro missed a wide open net.
Whoa, hold it here. That was a save by Caron's stick. That was a save by the stick of Caron. What a save. Oh, my.
He came around the net, and I tried to get as fast as possible in front, and he kind of waited a little bit. He kind of caught me off guard. He waited a little bit, and finally he tried to lift the puck behind my paddle, and I just lift my paddle at the same time, and it happened so quick, then, you know, it's pretty much hoping a career.
If you finish your season with 19 goals and you won 20, you'll think about those ones, and you know. So, guys were teasing me a bit.
We probably did give him a bit of a hard time, but in typical Ribeiro fashion, probably didn't listen to anyone and just shrugged it off.
The first four are done. Coming up, we kick our way into the top six.
Kiprusoff kicks that out of midair.
As a legend reaches for a milestone.
I knew it was going to be my 500th win if I do pull it off.
The top six NHL saves are next. Last season, Mika Kiprusoff of the Calgary Flames faced 1,935 shots. He stopped 1,753 of them. He would have liked more because Calgary didn't make the playoffs. But this, we think, is some of his finest work. Here's the Kipper coming in at number six.
Last second, so the puck is going in, and I just tried to do something.
Douglas Murray, rink wide, looking for a lane.
You know, I remember thinking Kipper was down and out.
He was down and out. He's on his belly.
Boyle throws it to the net, hits the side of the goal.
I saw the puck going up over him, heading into the net, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, he just kind of kicked his foot back up and kicked it out of the net.
Kiprusoff kicks that out of midair. You want to talk athleticism. You want to talk competing. Watch
that
save. Oh, my gosh.
Theatrical save by Kiprusoff with eyes in the back of his head.
So many saves goalies make him, and they're out already. It's empty net, and just try something.
And the officials now conferencing with Toronto.
It happened so quick. I didn't really realize he kicked it with his heel.
You know, you see the puck going over and you're like, oh, just a bad feeling. And then out of nowhere, he made just an unbelievable save.
I was kind of shaking my head. I was like, that just didn't happen. I saw it on TSN and the highlights, and it was just kept repeating and shot to my ego because I never really scored many goals, and I really could have used that one.
Did you really just save that? I'm like, oh, save me a minus. So I was pretty happy about that.
I remember hitting him in the head.
Blast. Miller hit him in the face, shook him up. Miller is shaken up on the Murray blast. Miller is now checking, see whether he's bleeding or not.
I think they can shake it off quite well, and he did come back and make that save on Pauly.
Now the Bruins break 2-on-1.
I think I might have been on the ice for that back checking.
Savard and Murray.
Quick 3-on-1, I think Savard was in the play.
2-on-1, Ludman back.
Knew he'd probably be a passer.
Savard for Murray, for Savard.
Committed myself to the, you know, getting over and back across, and you know, he gave it one more pass.
Late man, Mara. Miller makes a spectacular save.
We couldn't believe it that he came across like that and made that save.
Oh, what a stop by Ryan Miller. How did that not go in? That's as good a save as you'll see all year long.
Everybody thought it was an easy goal.
Unbelievable stop by Ryan Miller. He gets back again on Paul Mara.
He's a defenseman. They weren't really that surprised. No, I'm just kidding. Good friends with Pauly Mara.
Midair.
We definitely had it on pause in the locker room the next day for practice. I don't think Pauly saw many passes for the next two or three games.
Now the Bruins break 2-on-1. Savard and Murray, 2-on-1, Ludman back. Savard for Murray, for Savard. Late man, Mara. Miller makes a spectacular save. Oh, what a stop by Ryan Miller. How did that not go in?
The feeling I had as a coach with Marty Brodeur that there was no puck that he couldn't stop as long as he saw it. I didn't care where it was shot, what angle was shot from. If he had any type of vision on it, he had the ability to adjust.
We all knew that, you know, what was at stake and how big the event was.
499 victories for Martin Brodeur, shooting for 500. Number 500 is going to happen. Will it be tonight?
I know we had the lead, and I knew it was going to be my 500th win if I do pull it off. So, you know, I was just real focused.
Green follows up and chipped one that went off of Jones, and a chance now for Briere. Briere fed it across. Knubel, a shot, save Brodeur, rebound, Briere. Marty Brodeur was able to pin it.
And kind of made a save and kind of scoot back, and I had to, you know, throw my hand backwards.
Oh, beautiful save. Fantastic recovery. Oh, Marty.
Danny was right there, and he hammered it pretty hard.
Marty, you were at your best tonight. They're going to examine that one from up top.
At first, I wasn't sure if I was inside the net or not. When I saw it, you could tell that it was right on the goal line.
Even the crowd here, they watch it on the big board, are saying, whoa!
You get a little smile because I know a big save comes with a little luck. The next shift, he came over, he goes, wow, what a save, Marty.
It is done. 500 wins for Marty Brodeur.
When you're able to attach to a milestone, I think there's always a little more special.
We're down to the top three. A game saver turns into a series ender as the Habs knock off the Bruins. And how amazed will you be at the number one save?
You can't believe it. I guarantee you, the kid's never seen a save like that.
Find out next as the top 10 NHL saves continues.
When you think of the Montreal Canadiens and the Boston Bruins, and specifically goaltending, you think of Ken Dryden and Patrick Waugh and Gary Cheevers and most recently Tim Thomas. But in 2002, the Canadiens, they just snuck into the playoffs. And then thanks to Jose Theodore, they dumped the number one ranked Bruins.
I remember it well, unfortunately. It was a very intense series. There was a lot of emotions going on.
Oh, what a hit from McLaren! Oh my!
I don't care. This is what they did, and this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna go to their best player too.
This series has just gotten a little more intense.
Capacity crowd tonight of 21,273.
The fact that, you know, it was playoff game six in Montreal.
Five times the number eight seed has knocked off the number one seed. Will the Montreal Canadiens make it six?
We're up by one goal.
But Boston's got to win the draw. Surrey going back after it. Here's a shot of redirection. Off the post! No, Guerin could not jam it in.
Marty Lapointe. He shot it, hit the post. So I turned to follow if it was going in. So as I was turning, I kind of committed myself too much.
I just remember wide open net. The puck was actually rolling. I hit it hard. And Jose just came around and the puck hitting his stick, you know, flush.
We definitely thought it was in. We're turning and hugging each other, and we saw the replay, and I couldn't believe he made that save.
When it's the net cam, that's when you see exactly what happened. I didn't really realize what happened until I saw the replay.
Somehow Theodore out of position threw that hand back. Boston can't beat him. Well, I thought it was in when Guerin had it on his stick.
It was pretty deflating. I think that goal could have tied the game.
That they're out of the playoffs because of the man wearing number 60 for the Montreal Canadiens.
Even 9 years after, people say, oh, I saw your save you made against Boston. It's something that you can't really predict or you can't practice. It's just when you're in the game and you're in that special zone, you kind of, you know, find a way to make those kind of saves.
They stick with you because, you know, you always see them on the highlights, you know, no matter what. And you're like, yeah, I remember that well.
Maltz, you know, we had to work hard to get our goals, and something when it's going through like that, it deserves to go in.
7.5 to go now.
I believe it was in the third period. I remember coming down my off wing.
Here's Maltby racing in, left wing, the shot!
Maltz, you know, comes down, makes a great shot.
And it snuck through five hole.
The shot! Front wing, rebound, yes. Scored!
I was expecting it to go in, I was waiting for the horn to go.
And all of a sudden, Brathwaite turns around.
And it was trickling in, it was... I think he extended his stick back.
I just tried to wind to scoop it out, and somehow he just kept it out of the net.
I'm disbelief.
Here's Maltby racing in, left wing, the shot! Front wing, rebound, yes. Scored!
No!
No!
Oh my, I tell you something. How did that not go in?
He turns around in one motion, pulls the puck off the goal line, and pulls his stick, so it managed to get the puck off the line and actually elevates it somehow.
Somehow it ended up on top of my stick and lifting up in the air, and somehow he just kept it out of the net.
Miraculously, I don't know how he didn't put it in his net, but he was able to get his goal stick and kind of not just pull it back and get it into the corner, but with some oomph to it.
How it still didn't go in, I don't know. That is unbelievable.
But I had a pretty good view. I was right at the net kind of when he did it, so I knew it wasn't in, and I pretty much could have went over and told the refs, don't even waste your time.
And he's made some great saves tonight, but nothing equals this, especially with the timing of it.
Maltz had more times than any other guy that I've seen that were for sure goals that didn't go in.
He did get grief from Scotty, typical Scotty, and always he's gonna take it to a new level. He's like, hey, here's what happens, you don't follow your rebounds to net.
That was a goal that I was just waiting for it to go in. I mean, it was I was ready to add it to the scoreboard and score sheet and whatnot, but unfortunately most goalies got the better.
I mean, that's an absolutely remarkable no goal.
Doesn't get any closer than that.
We are down to number one.
You can put the blame on Fleury here in this situation.
Find out how a goalie change led to the number one save.
The light went on. The goal just turned the light on. You'll see it.
That's coming up next.
Crosby pulls up. Looks for Kunitz. The Guerin a shot. Oh! Ward somehow kept it out of the net. Billy Guerin right there on the doorstep. A tic-tac-toe play, and he looks back with that smirk as Cam Ward just pilfered Billy Guerin.
Savard lost it to Brown with Fedorov. Fedorov! Oh, what a stop! That's an amazing stop by Ed Belfour.
That's the best save I've seen in the playoffs.
Cromwell plays it back to Boston. Shoots Perry. Are you kidding? This is unbelievable. That was awesome. Way to go, Carey Price. Roberts moves it ahead to Fleury. Here he comes with Reichel. Fleury for Reichel. Great save by Kirk McLean. Perfect pass. McLean is there. Kirk McLean did not give up on the shot. 5-on-5. Brower with a long shot. Rebound. Again, out left the puck, it's centered, here's Brunette,
couldn't get it on his stick. But Gabrick, oh, how did that stay out? Gabrick with a gaping net. And was it Soleil or was it Jaguar?
I think it was Jaguar. Unbelievable.
On we go down to our number one moment. And remember, this is a subjective list. There are so many brilliant goaltenders. Wah, Hasek, Brodeur. But our number one save comes from a guy who played 92 NHL games and then had to find work in Europe. Here's Sebastian Caron.
I don't know. I'm trying to figure it out myself, too.
Crosby's looking at the goal like he can't believe it. I guarantee you, the kid's never seen a save like that.
Rushing back into the Penguins in the fourth, but back to Gagne, another goal. You can put the blame on Fleury here in this situation.
I think I started in second period. It's not an easy situation to come in, but you try to do your best, you know.
Booming shot this time. The Penguins get it on the pad. A rebound. Ben score.
Okay.
Line scores right from the faceoff. Moves out, goes to Young to it. Carstrom, he shoots and scores. They just scored to tie the game at five.
There was only a few minutes left in the third period, and it was tied 5-5.
Here he is carrying the mail to the Penguins' zone. And hit the post, rebound, score, Sammy. Are they going to rule no goal?
I thought I scored and, you know, did the dummy hand.
I just remember thinking, oh, geez, that's a goal for sure. And then his glove came out of nowhere.
You are not going to believe this save. Just watch it. You're not. You're not going to believe it, Mike. Can you believe that?
He robbed him. The light went on. The goal just turned the light on. You'll see it. I'll tell you, folks, that is an incredible save.
The reaction from Crosby pretty much tells the whole story.
I think actually my mom was the first one to mention anything about it, so pretty sure she knew I said stuff like that up to that point, but if she didn't, she saw it pretty clear there. Well, it happened so fast, and when I turned around, I didn't even know what was going on until I just opened my glove right up and the puck was in it.
The fans think it's been it's a goal. I think the goal just turned the light on.
Well, then you see the score, you know, on the TV, it says 6-5.
Folks, this is tremendous. The best save you'll ever want to see in the game of hockey.
Upstairs here, did Caron's glove go over the goal line?
No. I don't believe it did.
He said, oh my God, or something. So I think there's a couple extra words.
You could see by my reaction, I knew that it was pretty close. I couldn't believe that he could reach back that way. It was unbelievable athleticism.
Can you believe that?
He robbed him. The light went on. The goal just turned the light on. That is an incredible save.
Yeah, it's pretty high on my list. I didn't have many accomplishments in there, so it's kind of nice to get something like that.
Those are some amazing saves. We hope you enjoyed the show from all of us here. Thanks for watching. Make sure you tune in again for another SportsCenter Top 10 special. Bye-bye for now.